Yo, what's up? This is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Today, checking out ARPOLOGY by Sample Logic. This is a contact player library that's dedicated to ARPs and sequenced instruments. So, really crazy interface, and the sequencer is very, very powerful. That's the main part of it. You can also drag and drop MIDI from the sequencer into your DAW, so you can use it as a MIDI effect as well. So, very powerful. Of course, we're going to go in, kind of show you around the interface and see what it sounds like. So, let's check it out. All right, so here's the ARPOLOGY interface. Really nice interface, definitely powerful. You got your main controls up here with the randomization, speed, different play modes, swing, stutter. So you can have all the steps stutter at once, quantize settings, your step amount, octave, restart, and then your metronome. Then you can go down here. You actually have some more settings that you can set up, you know, for your randomization, you know, how random things are, your retrigger time, auto quantize, you can set up your invert, your mod wheel, different stuff like that. Right here you have your presets. You can load presets for the step sequence or the arpeggiator. You can see all those right there. You can actually save your own as well. There's your on off button for the arpeggiator. And then here's the arpeggiator. This is a really, really powerful sequencer. Each step you can change the note. It can be a note, it can be a stutter, glide. You can have it in free play mode or, you know, alternating. You got your different velocity right here, your step lengths, your ARP types, transpose, duration, your stutter rates. You can have different stutters for each individual step, your panning. Then you can assign whatever you want to the mod wheel, as you can see right there. And if you want to say, you know, adjust the velocity of everything at once, click that chain and it will all adjust together. And you see these R's right here. These are actually for the random button. So if it's green, that means it will be randomized. If it's not green, then it will not be randomized. Then you come over here to the effects section. You got your basic effects here. You can go into your mixer. You got your mixer settings for the sample, the wave, and the master. You got your different triggers. So you know how they do it, where you got the different effects and you can trigger them via key switch or whatever. Then you got your LFO settings right here, so you can send your LFO to different parameters. So really, really cool stuff. Of course, you got your effects up there. Let's say if you want to go in and adjust the filter, you click on filter, you see it right there, and you can actually set up a step sequence for, you know, these different parameters. You can turn that on and off. So really, really a lot of control and a lot of modulation options. But as you can see, there's a lot of content in here, so I want to go through and kind of show you what's what, give you a little bit of an understanding of how it works. So right now I'm in the cinematic organic folder, and then I'm gonna just go through, kind of adjust some settings and let you see what's going on. So as you can see, I actually have the Touch OSC template that they created for this, which gives you some control over different parameters like the filter and lo-fi distortion, different stuff like that. And then you also have a way to latch the ARP. You can freeze the ARP, randomize it. You got glide, stutter, quantize, all that stuff you can do directly from here. And you can go through the presets. So let's say I want to click a preset, and I can just start going through. As you can see, the presets are changing as I'm going through it. So really cool stuff there. You get the idea. And let's say you don't want the ARP on. You know, that's one thing that I want to make sure you understand. Just because it's called ARPOLOGY doesn't mean you have to play it with the ARP. You can actually turn it off and just play the sounds as you wish. So it's still a huge library of high quality instruments from Sample Logic. It just has a really, really high powered dedicated arpeggiator in there. And another thing that's cool about the ARP is you see right here the MIDI drag and drop. Anything you build in there, you can actually drag and drop. Now, if I were to have more steps, I would start seeing pages right here, and this would let me automatically scroll through them, or I can just leave that off and go to each page as I need. You can go up to 64 steps. Mm-hmm. you can see, man. Cool stuff. I can go down, I change the step of the note, I can go around here and change the step of the stutter, lots of stuff. So definitely not gonna be able to show you everything in here. I'm gonna just go through the different, you know, folders and give you a feel for the sounds. Let's check out maybe a couple more. See, man, really, really cool. And like I said, this thing is powerful, very, very powerful. I love the way you can go in to each individual step and do exactly what you want. You can see you got all these different options for the step lengths. You got all these different options for the stutters. So really cool stuff, all the transpose and everything. And like I said, being able to go in and change those presets, really, really cool, and save your own presets. So let's check out some of the electronic stuff. Again, the arpeggiator is powerful, but the sounds themselves sound really good also. So, like I said, the arpeggiator is powerful, but the sounds, even if you just turn that off and you just want the sounds, it's a really cool library for that as well. See, there's tons and tons of stuff in here. I'm definitely not going to be able to go through everything, but hopefully you're getting a good idea of what it sounds like and what you can do with it. As you can see, man, it's really easy to go in and just get lost in the sounds, man. It's really fun to play with this arpeggiator. Like I say, really powerful, and the fact that you can drag and drop that MIDI directly into your DAW, really, really cool. So you can use it as an effect. If you just want to use the arpeggiator, come up with some different, you know, sequences, drag it into your DAW, you can do that as well. If you want to bypass the arpeggiator and just play the sounds, which sound great, you can do that. So really cool stuff. say, man, I want to go in and kind of mess with some of the transposing. So I kind of go up here and maybe come down over here. You can just, you know, randomly do whatever you want. Or you can just turn random on for this and randomize it. So. I can just go in and play whatever I want, or I can turn the ARP on. You see cool stuff. So let's see. Got a bunch of stuff in here. Maybe do a couple more of these, then we'll go to the next folder. Man, this thing is just, these guys are crazy, man. Like I said, this thing is really, really fun and really, really easy. Like, there's a lot going on, but it's really easy to understand and just manipulate. So, let's see, maybe we'll do one more in here. Let's check out Pretty Lights. So you can see, and there's a ton of instruments in here, so a lot of content. I don't want to say one more, but we'll do another one. Why not? And again, say I want to turn it off and just hear what that sounds like. So really cool stuff. Like I said, the main focus of this library is the arpeggiator, which is really, really fun, really powerful. But again, you can go in and simply turn it off if you just want to play the sounds on your own. And like I said, that MIDI drag and drop for the ARP really makes it powerful. Let's go into, I just want to kind of show you how much stuff is in there so you can see lots of content. Let's go into another folder. We'll go into the percussive. So you got some different drums and stuff in here. See that, man? Just really, really easy to go in and change things. You can see going in, playing melodic, you know, sequences with your percussion. Really, like I said, it's really powerful. You know, you got all these different presets in there that you can mess with as well. So just wanted to go through some of those also. So again, lots of different rhythmic things. Then I also want to make sure to show you some of the multis. you get the idea. Let's do a couple more of these, and then we'll check out some of the multis. You can see how it is, man. Really cool stuff. And then you got some multis, of course. So you got the instrumental stacks and the one note glories. Now each one's going to be different in terms of control, and there's also a template on the iPad for that. You can actually, there's a page in there where you can control this stuff. So I'm gonna pull it up. How many controls you get depends on the multi, so it's going to vary from each one. But you can see right there, this one has two. Again, just crazy. I mean, the quality, of course, is really, really nice, but I just love the control, and I love, you know, the way they did the ARP. It's really cool. Drums in and out, so cool stuff. Check out a few more of these, and then we'll check out, of course, you know, the one note glories where you just one finger and it goes crazy. So you can see this one has a button and two knobs, so I know it's long, but again, there's so much stuff in here, man. This was bound to be a long one just because it's a really, really cool instrument. I just want to make sure you fully understand what you can do with it. And then, of course, you got a bunch of those, so really cool stuff. And then finally, let's check out the one note glory. You got to do that. Sounds amazing. Really, I mean, their stuff is just awesome. Straight sounds like stuff, type of stuff you hear in movies and, you know, TV shows and all that stuff. I also always love the names of their stuff. Sharks on Land. That's, you know, Sharknado type stuff right there. Don't act like you didn't watch Sharknado. I know you saw it. So crazy stuff. I appreciate you staying around for so long, but again, this is just a fun instrument, man. I really wanted to, and it's huge. There's a lot of stuff going on, so I wanted to make sure you knew what was up. And that just sound, that's beautiful stuff right there. one more. See what the think tank sounds like. Alright, I know I said one more, but I lied. This will be the last one. I'm just having fun, man. It's a really cool instrument. All right, man, I'll keep going all night because this thing is really, really fun and it sounds great. I love how powerful it is, and I love the way they did the arpeggiator. It's really, really, you know, you can just go in and tweak it. Every individual step, all the different controls are right there. Really makes it easy to manipulate. Actually, let's take a look at it one more time just so you can remember what's going on. You can see, man, I mean, the interface, they did a really good job. This arpeggiator is really cool, and the fact that you can just drag it, you know, drag the MIDI data directly to your DAW, use it on different plugins or instruments is really cool. So let me know what you think about this, man. I give it a 5 out of 5 subs. I think it's a really, really great product. I think they did a good job. I love the fact that there's an iPad, you know, template to go with it as well. Just gives you a little bit more control, a little bit more diversity over how you want to play with this thing. But even if you don't use the iPad app, you know, just the way they have the interface set up is really cool, and the fact that you can drag and drop to your DAW, man, makes it really, really powerful. And of course, it sounds good, which is the most important thing. So let me know what you think. Remember, you can get this directly from the Sample Logic website, as you can see right there, $399.99. This is a Kontakt Player library, so you don't need the full version of Kontakt to use it. It will work with the Kontakt Player if that's what you have. So let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. Thanks for sticking around for so long. I think it was a fun one, man. Definitely worth it. So let me know what you think. This is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com, Sample Logic, ARPOLOGY, 5 out of 5 subs. I'll see y'all later. Peace.